you'd better without them. Well, without them, I would be a crash risk. I never really cared about fashion. I figure there's no use in pretending. There's really no shame in being different. Why would kids pick on you for your vision? I was talkative at home, but at school I was shy. Someone would talk smack and I'd go hide and cry. Until I put the smack down and stood up for my rights. I thought no one cared at one point in my life. Like if I were to die, only if you would cry. But over time I realized, although their opinions didn't matter, the more they screamed, my problems screamed louder. I was becoming so angry. Does someone need to save me? Am I nothing but a coward? But I've evolved a lot from back then. I feel so proud of myself for holding on when I felt little power. Sometimes you need to give it all to a higher power. Sometimes you need to look at who all surrounds you. Sometimes it comes down to just you standing alone in an empty room with some thinking to do and a decision that you gotta choose. But you're feeling like either way you will lose, and everybody around you wants you to. Cause once you acquire trust issues, you become translucent like glass, in which you shatter based off your past, saying that you may shine some light in my life, but no one can pass through. Stay true to you. If I had a full warning, I'd be hesitant to let you in, cause you're negligent. But lest I forget, I'm not a pessimist. I promise to stay as real as it gets when I say that there's true evidence to back my claims. If they're coming with a dagger of flames, they'll always say that they've changed, acting like they're renewed and revitalized. This relationship is ending in the final inning. Even if they bat their eyes, they're not getting three strikes, cause it only take one to knock them out like a light. But that's never what anyone wants, right? So you spend your free time keeping up the fight, trying to be involved with someone no matter the spite. But why? You're doing just fine with the circle you have. You are so blessed, you should be glad. People come and go almost like a fad. So I started doing something that I love, like rap. When you convert that energy to passion and find a piece to appease you, that's long lasting, more like everlasting. Instead of casting out your reel, fishing for someone who at least feels real, you start crushing hard when you try to make a deal. When you compromise yourself, you basically kill your self-worth, cause you deserve to just chill. You can't fit into some cheap thrill, cause there's more fish in the sea. If it seems risky, time to start cutting off some gills. Stay true to you. For you, they just want to see you found. I built my foundation up brick by brick, all the way from dirt, every stone and hinge. You can call me a prick cause I like revenge, but success is the best revenge you can get, and you can never take that away from me. When I was feeling low, when I was down, when I was feeling angry, when I felt like life wasn't even worth it, I rose above and I went out and earned it. It took a lot to get where I am now, where my temper can finally calm down. I've made mistakes, I'll take the blame now, but I lived in a world where I was always torn down. But now I can actually say I'm happy, truly deep in my soul and core, and I found worth fighting for. And in this life there's so much more, so I cannot wait to see what's in store. And I'm so grateful for all the support I had from those close to me when I felt so torn. I did it even when I swore that there was no way out, so I'm using this voice that I have to shout. Don't have a persona that isn't you. You may have doubts, but you gotta stay true. Stay true.